Hey y'all, what's up? So today's video, I want to talk about my lighting, my setup and everything, because I already put up a video showing my makeup station, and that's pretty much my setup for my lighting and everything. But I really wanted to do a separate video to talk about my lights and everything, where I got them, also just some alternatives, because I didn't always have these lights and I always didn't have the setup, so I figured I would do like some alternatives. But the first thing I will talk about is my lighting, of course. The best lighting that I have is natural light when I film in front of the window, like I'm doing now. I'm filming in front of my window, and it's actually really pretty outside. It's real sunny. So I find that filming in natural light, if you can film by a window or just get the most natural light that you can, that is really the best light that you could possibly get. If you don't want to go out in stores and get all the lamps and everything, just film by a window. It's free, and you don't have to worry about buying light bulbs and nothing. Natural light is free, and it's the best light that you can get. But if you don't have natural light and you can't film next to a window, or if you're the way your house is set up, you don't have a whole lot of light coming in, you can also get some lamps. The lights that I'm using, my umbrella lights, I got those from Amazon, and they were $40. It came with the stand, it came with the light, two light bulbs, and it came with the actual umbrella that goes on the front. I don't have the umbrella on the front of mine now. But it comes with the two umbrellas on each one. It comes with the light bulbs and the stand and everything. And it was only $40. It's really affordable, and it really gets the job done. Now, if you don't want to order off Amazon and you want to just go in the store like Walmart and see if you can see what you can find for real cheap, what I was using before I got those lights was just regular desk lamps. And I'm trying to get the lamps so I can show you. But these are, wait a minute, I'm trying to get it so I can show you. This is just a regular desk lamp, and it just has the white shade around it, and just any kind of, you can use like a white light bulb. I'm using just a regular one. But these were $5. It was only $5, so you can find this at Walmart, and you can get like two or three of them if you want to have like one on each side, like one on each side of your table, and there's just one in the center. You can do that, or if you can just use two, that'll be fine too. Because before I had those, I was using just regular desk lamps, and I just had one on each side. So you can use either these, or if you want to go a little more professional, you can just get some softbox lights from Amazon or just the umbrella lights. So those are pretty much the lights that I use. Like I said, I film in front of my window, and I get natural light in from my window. But if you can't get light in from your window, you can also just get some lights from some lights from Amazon, the umbrella lights or the softbox lights. I don't have the softbox. I just have the regular umbrella lights. But you can get either one of those, or you can just go to Walmart and pick up some desk lamps like those. And those are only $5 a piece. Now, as far as my camera, the camera I use is my JVC Averio. It's not an HD camera. I wish it was, but it's not HD. I just film in front of my window to try to get the best light in, and their lighting really helps the camera. So I just film in front of my window. I wish it was HD, but it's really not HD. Now, I got my camera from the pawn shop. and it was $175, and it was still in the box and everything. I think it was pretty much brand new, because I mean, it had everything in there, and it was pretty much brand new. It still had the tape and everything on the screen. It still had all that on it. So I think it was pretty much still pretty new. So I think the regular price on my camera, it was supposed to be like $300, but I ended up getting it for $175, and it's really saved me some money. But yeah, that's the camera I use. And before I had that camera, I was actually using just a regular digital camera. Just a regular digital camera. But this actually was not the actual camera that I was using. The actual camera that I was using, it was, I think it broke or something. I don't know what happened to it, but it just stopped working. But this one is just a regular digital camera. I got it from Walmart. It was $99, and it's, the Canon PowerShot, I think. Yes, the Canon PowerShot A1400, and it supposedly is HD. That's the name on the top. And this one is a really good camera. It takes really nice pictures. The video quality is actually pretty good if you can get a good amount of light. If you're shooting in like natural daylight or outside, it'll be a really good light. But if you're shooting with like artificial light, it'll probably come off a little too orange. But it's actually pretty good. The only thing about this camera is the sound. When you film with it, the sound is not as clear as it is if you was using like a camcorder or just a really nice high quality camera. But the video quality on it is pretty good. The only thing is the sound is not as good. If you like to do tutorials doing voiceovers, then this would be a pretty good camera to use. It was only $99, so you can find it at Walmart. So as far as my setup and everything, I just have my tripod, and I got a tripod from Walmart. It was only like, I want to say $14 or $15. it really wasn't expensive at all. I just got like a regular tripod from Walmart, and I just set my I just set my camera on my windowsill, and then I just pretty much get the light in from the window. But that's pretty much how I get my light in from my window. And a tripod is really good because you can really just set up the camera how you want it. If you want the angle coming from up high and looking down, you can do that. Or if you just if you can't hold the camera with both hands, or if you just can't sit the camera up on something, a tripod is really helpful. It's only $15. It's really not that much. Really not too much. They also help if you want to film like an outfit of the day and you don't have somebody to help you film. You can just set the tripod up, and then it'll really just help have the camera steady, and you won't have to worry about the camera moving all around. So that's pretty much my setup and everything. Like I said, I try to film with natural daylight, and if I don't have natural daylight, I use my umbrella lights. Or if I just if it's real gloomy outside and I just want a little extra light, I would turn on my umbrella lights from that I got from Amazon. But if you don't have either one of those, if you can't get natural light in from your window and you don't want to order offline, you can just go to Walmart and get some of these desk lamps. Like I said, they're only $5, and you can get some daylight light bulbs. So as far as the light bulbs and these lamps, you really want to make sure that you get a white light bulb, because if you get one of those regular light bulbs like the one I have in now, if you have one of those, then the colors will come off wrong, especially if you're doing like makeup tutorials or swatches or anything. It really won't show up right. It'll show up too warm. It won't show up as true to color as it would say like if you was using like regular just normal daylight. So that's pretty much my setup and everything. I hope this video was helpful. If you have any questions or anything, maybe like where I got anything, I pretty much mentioned it in the video. But if you have any other questions, just list it down, put it down in the comment section, and I will get back to you. So that's pretty much it. Thank y'all for watching, and I'll see y'all on my next one. Bye.